Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss few tips for group discussion. Okay, group discussion in most of the companies, group discussion will be one of the round in which most of the people will be rejected. Okay, now in this video, we are going to discuss few tips on how to crack group discussion. Okay, now let's begin. My first tip is be a good listener. Okay. In companies, we have to work under team, okay? We have to work along with other people. So, we always have to be a good listener. So okay, the person who are going to judge your marks in group discussion will see for this quality in you, okay? You should always be a good listener, okay? Try to listen and always listen show interest on what others are saying. Okay, always prove that you are a very good listener. Second tip is use easy words and sentences. Okay, the person who is judging you in a group discussion will not expect hi-fi language or hi-fi words or hi-fi English from you. You always have to use easy words and easy sentence because it should be easily understood by other person. Okay, whatever you say should be easily understood by opposite person in the team. Okay, so always use easy words and sentences. Okay, next tip is respect other opinions and ideas. Okay, coming to companies, there will be meetings held regularly in which all people have to give ideas, in which you should never be dominant, or you should never behave as if your idea is the best. Okay, always respect other opinion in and ideas. Okay, that's why the person who is evaluating you, who is observing you in group discussion, will also see for this quality that you should always respect other opinion and feelings and their ideas. Okay, so always respect others' feelings, opinions and ideas. Okay, next tip is think analytically and logically in group discussion. They'll be giving you 90%, they'll be giving you the most common topic where everybody can discuss or where everybody will have knowledge. Okay, so but in rare cases they may ask to discuss on few topics where you don't have any idea or where you don't have correct knowledge. In that case, you have to think analytically and logically. I'll tell you why. Means there's an topic which they have asked you to discuss about and you don't have any idea about the topic, then start thinking logically and take a pen and paper and start noting down the points which are told by others. Like in the discussion, they'll be telling you their points, right? So whatever point you felt correct, whatever point you agree, just write the points and start repeating them by adding your analytical and logic points. Okay, so this will help you in cracking the group discussion. So always think analytically and logically. Next, be active and spontaneous. Be active means in group discussion there will be some common 5 to 6 people sitting in a circular shape and start discussion. Like they'll be discussing about the topic. Okay, you should always be active and enthusiastic what others are saying. Okay, always be active and show your interest, that you are interested and eager to know what others are saying. Okay, always be active and spontaneous means if one of the person have opposed your point, disagreed your point, then you have to be spontaneous and give few examples why you agreed on that point. Okay, always be spontaneous in group discussion. Initiate the group discussion. Now I'm going to tell you an important point. The person who initiates, means the person who starts the group discussion, will get one extra point, and the person who concludes the group discussion also will get an extra point. So always try to be an initiator and concluder if possible. Okay, and next is maintain eye contact while speaking. Okay, if you maintain eye contact, it shows your confidence level. Okay, it shows your strength. Okay, if you does not maintain eye contact, then it will give chance to other person to think what to argue with you, like how to disagree with your point. So always maintain eye contact, so that he or she also have to maintain eye contact with you, so that they will not think about their points of disagreement. Means example, I will tell you the example. There are two persons, okay? When you maintain the eye contact, he is agreeing on the point, like you are discussing on a point, like you are example, banning the crackers. Okay, you are saying yes, it's good to ban the cracker, but this person is saying no, it is not good to ban the crackers during Diwali. Okay, if you maintain the contact level, he or she also have to maintain the same contact level with you. So when he concentrates on your speech, he will not have chance to think the points to disagree or to stop your discussion. So always maintain the eye contact, so that it will help you to not give chance others to oppose your point or argue with your point. Okay, always maintain eye contact while speaking with others in group discussion. Okay, next, allow others to speak. Means never you should be dominant, like always I will only speak. Never you should have that kind of attitude. Always allow others to speak. Okay, give chance to others to speak, but it doesn't mean that you should not speak. You have to also speak, and as well as you have to allow others also to speak. Okay, next, positive attitude means while others speaking, you should not shake your legs, or you should not break your knuckles, or you should not lean back or lean front, which causes disturbance to the speaker. Okay, always show the positive attitude, like sit straight, maintain your body posture, maintain correct body language and all. Okay, that comes under positive attitude. And time management means if there are 6 people in the group discussion and the group discussion time is 15 minutes, equally divide 15 minutes to 6 people and make sure first 30 seconds and last 30 seconds is left for initiation and conclusion. Okay, remaining 14 minutes should be equally divided to all the 6 people. Okay, make sure there is correct time management. Okay, they are not going to, the person who is evaluating you in group discussion is not going to extend the time. So always time management is so much important to conclude the topic within the time. Okay, these are few tips for group discussion which are to be followed in order to crack the group discussion and get a job. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm going to do more and more videos about the interview skills, do's and don'ts in group discussion and technical rounds, aptitude, HR rounds and all. So for that, what you need to do is just subscribe to my channel for more such videos and hit the bell icon so that you will get the notification whenever I upload a video. Thank you so much for watching this video, and all the very best for your interview.